What y'all got on special?
Hey, bartender, how much for a shot, man?
Can I get a shower on the ride up?
Do you got a blue motorcycle?
Sex on the rocks.
Oh, okay. Me, my bad.
Yo, what's...
I wasn't paying attention. All right, yeah. Yo, you know what? Fuck every last one of y'all.
Welcome to
Sex on the Rocks podcast.
What she want to do tonight.
Shut up.
She confused as fuck.
Whatever.
Hey, it's me, Quentin Quasi. Y'all already know what it is. I got my co-host, Tiffany. What's good?
What up?
And we got a guest in the building tonight. I want to let him introduce himself, but he got his own podcast called F the Culture. I
know I said it right now. You did. My man Wayne would be proud. I appreciate it, man. What's up, man? It's Drew. Drew knows best. Twitter, Instagram, all that. I'm so honored to be here, man. I fuck with y'all.
I do, too. I fuck with me, too, man. I know. Definitely appreciate that. It's definitely reciprocated, man. I listened to a couple of your shows.
Appreciate it.
Last week. Definitely had to get acclimated who the hell we was meeting.
Right, right. No, I respect that. Yeah, you got to be like, who is this nigga?
Oh, yeah. So I'm uncovered a little bit. We're going to talk about that later. But first, let's go over our normal shit, our personal weekly recaps.
Okay. So on a week of 1 to 10, being 10 being the best blowjob you've had, 1 being super dry and whack, how would you rate your week?
Man, this week, had cottonmouth.
Oh, so you had like a 1.
Oh, man.
It was like a 3.
A 3, okay. Well, that's some movement.
I had some good shit at work, but at home that shit was a cottonmouth.
What's going on at home?
It was just whack. It was just a whack ass week, dog.
What happened?
It's just a whack ass week.
You want the details and shit. Q got girl problems, y'all. Q got girl problems. You got wife problems.
That's wifey shit. You gotta keep it to yourself.
Oh, man. All right, cool. You just gotta work that shit out.
What's up with you?
You know, I don't have.
You dry. You spit on it before.
Let's see. On head. You know what I'm saying? I had like this is kind of like a mediocre ass week. I didn't have to work this weekend, thank God. So like, I did some shopping, got some stuff for my house, well, my condo, and just ooh, you know, had a ooh, regular
flex
ass.
Ooh, flex on him.
You know what I'm saying?
My
girl's doing well. Shut up. And, you know, I just was preparing for next week because next week at work is going to be super fucking hectic because we have one of our best leaving us. So, yeah. But real quick, I want to talk about hating ass hoes in the workplace. I just want to let you know that.
Speak on it, queen.
You know what I'm saying? If you are trying to be considered for a promotion or, you know, a step up in the corporate ladder, you have to carry yourself like you want to be a step up on the corporate ladder. You can't be going to work looking like whodunit. You can't be going to work in fucking stretched out stretch pants with holes in them, flip flops, your hair looking all crazy. You don't wash your face. You don't brush your teeth. You put no effort. You fucking smell sometimes. And then you're going to come for people who are getting considered for promotions because you feel like you've been there longer, so you have seniority. I'm letting you know, none of that shit matters. It's about what you're doing right now. It's about how you're presenting yourself, especially if you are a black woman and you work with a bunch of white people. You better know how to fucking carry yourself, because in these sort of promotions and, you know, climbing up, you're going to be around different personalities. You're going to be around, you know, a lot more white people. So you need to know how to fucking carry yourself. And I'm not talking about your character, how you speak. I'm talking about just in how you look and how you present yourself. And that is all I have to say.
Wow.
In other words,
damn, son. Where'd you find that one?
Bitch don't come to tip.
That's just saying.
Right.
Seriously, I don't have a lot of problem with females. I'm on my business and I'm pretty cool. But if I see you, you know what I'm saying, like you trying to sabotage some shit or you're finding out I'm being considered for certain things and you're trying to throw obstacles in my way, that shit is not cool. Like, I don't ever bring down another woman, especially a fucking another black woman. Like, I want to see you do good. You should want to see me do well. So, I mean, it's just fucked up, but that's just how it is. An eye for an eye, you know, that's just how it's got to be. So that's how it's going to be.
I can definitely feel you on that.
All right.
I sent them in a little bit. I mean, I had a kind of a good week at work. Okay. I saw somebody that looked like me in a position that I wanted to be in.
Oh, okay.
I mean, y'all know I'm trans.
Look like you, like light skin?
There you go.
No, I mean, like, no, I'm serious.
I think you're just referring to a black man doing good.
Okay,
yo,
my bad.
Like me.
Yeah. Okay, okay.
Because like I said, y'all know how I'm traditional from teaching. I'm from the classroom. Now I'm in this corporate world. I don't like talking to people for no fucking reason. That's just not me. I'm not a social butterfly sometimes. I can be if I had to be, but it's not my thing. But I met a guy, I rap with him for real. Cause, like, he looked like me. He weighed type of swag I wear. His hair was kind of like mine. It's not clean cut and all of that.
So the nigga was cute.
No. But no, I got a lot of homies that I work with there, and they more so, Q, you gotta cut your hair if you wanna move up, y'all.
True.
Okay.
I'm like, dog, I've been clean cut for the last 10 years.
You do got a natural, I think that's curly thing going. I like it.
I definitely agree with you on that one, because I hate that whole, like, we gotta look, we gotta conform and stuff like that. Like, why? You know what I'm saying? I think the world's moving differently now. Yeah. So why would I need to look like nigga from 20 years ago, you know, so like our dads used to look like, for what?
But you still used to look like you've taken a bath and, you that's know, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
put some oils, you know what I'm saying?
Something, put some coconut oil on them elbows, girl. Sorry, I had a flashback. So true. How was your week on a scale of 1 to 10 blowjobs, 10 being the best?
I would say 11.
11. Oh, that's the first on the show. Yeah. Ding, ding, ding. So we need to put an applause in there.
Actually got some hit this week.
Oh, no, I got 11. All that. Well, you know, my girl lives in Florida, so, you know, we plan everything out, da-da-da-da. So, at the beginning of this week, I was still in Orlando. Then we drove down to, she lives in Fort Lauderdale, and went to this Free Henny event, and then...
Is that Free Henny?
Yeah, that's... Yo, I gotta move. I'm sorry. It's crazy. Yeah, it was a Free Henny event. All you do is RSVP. We went there, they showed us how to make these little drinks and stuff, and then they gave you a bottle of Henny, like, not just the regular joint either, like, the one I ain't paying for.
I'm not a big Henny fan, so I'm not.
I'm not either, but I like free stuff.
Yeah, but I like free stuff.
Give me some pineapple juice or something.
Yeah, Henny or pineapple is a crowd favorite.
Yeah. Then you know, we was out there on regular Miami, you know, Miami shit. Out, da da da. I went to the sex museum. Mm. Yeah, it was interesting. If you saw my joint, right?
I think
the wall of labias.
Oh, yeah.
It was cool, though. Yeah, it was a good trip. And, of course, saw the misses, and, you know, I handle business, so.
Yeah.
It was a good week.
Drew, I call Drew the horn dog, because.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Like, that's definitely. All. Drew's the horn dog. And he's like, you know, my girl, she always happy. I say, you know what, you're right. She always smiling, cheesing in all the pictures. So, yeah, you absolutely right.
That's a fact.
So, this episode is very exciting for me.
Long awaited.
Shit,
2.5 episodes.
Listen. It's been some schedule conflicts. It's been some, you know, baby daddy drama. It's been some fucking, it's just been a lot of shit going on. So finally we bring to you the fantasy episode. So I know that I've been posting just kind of questionnaires from you guys. We got a lot of good feedback we're going to go over. So I do also want to get into some icebreakers with our guest. If he's willing.
I'm with it.
Yeah. Okay.
You know me.
Before we get started. So, a lot of you guys are probably more familiar with him than you are with me. But that's okay, because it's my show. All right, so, do you want to start, Q?
All right. So since you it sounded like you had the most sex this week.
Oh,
definitely. Between the three of us, it looked like you had the most. Definitely. So
we didn't ask Magic, though.
I don't know. Is Magic, you on the mic today?
He always happy.
Everybody got, we forgot to introduce our engineer. Oh, I've been throwing him on the bus all episodes so far.
Your shit.
All I'm saying is it better be recorded this time. Right?
We recording? We good?
We straight.
All right, cool.
We straight. My week was pretty good, though.
Okay, 1 to 10.
You know what's funny? It's like an 8-ish. But I bagged a chick that worked at the job of somebody else that I'm also talking to.
Nice.
So that
nice
was
and messy.
Was,
I like it.
That was interesting.
Remind me of my young years.
I told her I bagged her, but I told her I told her that her friend worked there, but or the girl worked there. I didn't tell her who she was, though. So,
well, at least you was kind of honest.
Like, yeah, is that your girl?
No,
then it don't matter.
Yeah, exactly.
The fuck?
Exactly.
You gave her like 85.
Yeah. I'm not gonna give her all the details. Yeah, I'm like, look. She told me, you know, she works there.
That's better than what I would have gave. I would have said nothing.
Nah, yeah, because I'd be like, oh, yeah. If anything, I'd probably be like, yeah, I know a chick that I know a chick that worked there.
Like, you like, yo, you know Tasha? Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah, exactly. That ain't my girl.
I had to.
What I owe her?
Nah, nothing.
What?
I'm an honest person, and to an extent.
I just want
to
say that I'm surrounded by boys to fuck boys right now. Fucking three men over here. I wouldn't have told her nothing. Are you fucking serious?
Everybody listening, mark this time right now in your timestamp. In 20 minutes, she's going to tell you some bullshit she did. I'm going to be like, wow, that's crazy.
That's her favorite thing to do.
Nothing. All right, well, I hope that all works out for you. You don't walk outside to, you know, slash tires.
Nah, it usually works out.
Okay.
I told you I'm gifted.
That's a fact.
Here you go with the shit.
Oh,
here
you go.
All right, so question number one.
Not his dick.
Oh, is that what he meant?
Yeah.
Okay.
He talks about his dick and he has a, what is it, bidet?
First of all,
a bidet?
I have a bidet in my bathroom.
That's weird, but I'm not mad at it. But I'm not. No.
I was surprised. I'm not mad at it.
I walk in the bathroom. Tiff got it on blast. It is hitting the wall. I'm like, what are you doing? She's like, I wanted to see how it works.
I wanted to see how it works.
I'm not used to luxury.
That's nice, though.
Yeah. Okay.
That's like
all right.
Clean. That's like that buddy.
You gotta make sure. Like, you gotta make sure. Like,
he be getting his buddy.
You gotta go freshen that shit up real quick.
That's for the girl. You know, I gotta get down in between them cheeks.
I hear you, though. That's smooth.
All right. So, yeah. Icebreaker number one. We need to get over this shit. Icebreaker number one.
Real quick. Every time I hear a guy talk about eating ass, like, if it's a guy that I liked, I know that it's not going to work. Because I never want to kiss him. Like, I never want to think about that.
Do you ever get your ass eaten?
Of course.
But you don't kiss him afterwards?
She don't want the nigga to talk about it.
All right. So, how about this? If a guy comes in your mouth, do you kiss him?
Yeah, that's it.
But what if it's your ass?
It's
ours.
No, it doesn't matter.
How is it ours? That ain't.
You don't have a bidet.
So you have a bidet, though. That's what it is.
He has to kiss you. He has to possibly taste his cum.
What's wrong with that?
Taste your ass?
No, I can't.
But it's yours. Crazy.
It doesn't matter.
All right, do you taste your pussy?
And ladies and gentlemen,
the timestamp I was just talking about is here. Boom.
Hey, whatever. Whatever. All right, back to these icebreakers.
All right, number one. Like I said, since you had the most sex this week,
all right,
what's your definition of good sex versus bad sex?
All right. For me, good sex is that we ain't worried about what we broke or what we knocked over, like... It might be hot. You nigga might be sweating. Like, fuck it. We in all positions we want to get in and all that good stuff. We just in the moment. Bad sex is when there's obvious things like, hey, you, my phone's ringing. Can you do that? Hey, excuse me. The bed's slipping. The fitted sheet is slipping off. I hate when people are awkward like that. They want to do that kind of shit. So bad sex is when you're not even you're not really in it. You know what I'm saying? Like,
gotcha.
Having sex,
you think about other shit.
Right. Okay. Exactly. Right.
Does it matter if your partner comes or not?
Oh, every time.
Yes.
Every time.
All right. And that's what I'm saying. Some of y'all need to learn.
Of course. I mean, anybody that does not think. And that's the worst thing in the world. Why would you ever fake that for a guy?
Exactly. I don't fake it.
You're giving him false confidence.
Yeah, but you know,
he don't think, yeah, I fucked that bitch. Yo. I bust that shit. She loved my shit. And then he about to go to the next bitch and give her some whack ass shit. All while you go give your friends a bad report.
About you in her group text.
That's terrible.
But he's out here giving bad dick out. And y'all didn't.
You could have educated him real quick.
I don't do it anymore. I don't do it because I don't care about men's egos. But, you know, back when I did, when I was sensitive.
That's terrible.
Yeah, because you don't want to destroy a guy like that. For a guy to learn right like his dick is whack as fuck, that a lot of that will destroy him.
You don't tell him whack. You tell him what he can improve on.
Your shit is whack. It's whack.
Let me tell you something. The best thing that ever happened to me was I just started having sex when I was like 18, right? The third, fourth girl I ever had sex with was like, yeah, you are good. But and she gave me tips and she was like,
I bet you still communicate with her or something. You follow each other on Instagram or something.
Yeah, years ago, but still, I appreciated her. She gave me this. We had sex maybe like 3 more months and then that made me like malleable. Yeah, I'm using big words today. Any other girl that like was like, hey, you should do that. I'm like, oh, we can do that. And I'm a communicator. Like if I in a new relationship, whatever, like you into that, like post game report. So that was good, okay. Right?
Yes, okay. I fucking hate that post game report.
Oh my god,
I don't need to. I don't need to be like, was it good for you or was it bad for you? I don't need that. No,
yeah, that's how it be.
I don't want you to stroke the ego.
I feel like my body should tell you whether it was good or not.
But that's what I feel like. No, you can't tell me like, yo, you should have put your pinky in the butt, not the finger. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's
well, you know, certain things. Like, all right,
choke me a little harder, choke me a little softer.
Mm-hmm.
I just say that during it. But, you know, anyway.
But yeah, to end that question, make sure that whoever you are having sex with, guy or female, make sure the other person comes. I just feel like that is the worst thing in the world. Like, why are you fucking if you don't?